The World Health Organization considers the ongoing increase in COVID-19 cases in the Philippines as a spike in the current wave of infections. World Health Organization Philippine Representative Dr. Rabindra Abeyasinghe points out it's not a second wave since the country never flattened its COVID-19 curve. He adds the spike shows the need to strengthen health protocols on the ground.
We always knew that there was quite a thick chain of transmission, although the numbers went down at some stage to 300-400 on a daily basis. That still reflected significant levels of transmission in the community. So it would rather be another spike in the ongoing wave. There's actually no value in classifying it as first second wave or second wave. We really want the local leadership to lead in this effort so that we can ensure that we don't have to go back to a situation that we had last July, August, when we had to go to more larger level lockdowns and quarantining of populations.
As of Monday, the Philippines has recorded more than 597,000 COVID-19 cases after new infections topped 3,000 for four straight days. Metro Manila vows to intensify contact tracing efforts following the spread of new COVID-19 variants and the spike in new cases. The Metropolitan Manila Development Authority, or MMDA, says it will also implement stricter monitoring of patients in quarantine facilities. It also plans to beef up the enforcement of health protocols across the region.
My own personal observation, this is really behavioral as yeah. What has been on the papers. It's been 1 year now since we had this lockdown yeah. on March 17. It is called, of course, COVID fatigue.
Vico Soto said the same thing.
Yeah, medyo yeah. hindi nakatama, nakaganto, nakalabas na rito, nagmaskara pa,
Yeah.
May mga ganon. But one thing is, we are most vulnerable habang kumakain tayo.
Uh-oh.
Because when we eat, wala naman talaga mask eh.
Yes.
At kung minsan nangyayari sa mga offices, yes. kakain, parang salo-salo na eh dahil kampante na sa ka-opisina eh.
Yeah.
Or better yet, no, maski siguro yung mga magkakamag-anak na, kaya kung papansin ninyo yung mga ano yung clustering, talagang pami-pamilya eh. So we cannot avoid if we eat with family members. It's just yeah. that sabihan na lang natin sila always be careful.